If you look up how to do a spiral pass on the internet, which is something I had to do for this video because I really suck at throwing footballs, the main thing you'll see is that you need to position your fingers in a way that'll make the ball spin as it flies through the air. I was breaking my arm trying to do this so I could see a physics problem up close. And the problem is right here. When you throw a good spiral pass, the ball starts pointed up, tips over midair, and ends pointed down.
We're used to seeing a football do this, but according to physics, that's highly unusual. When we throw objects, they are usually going to either retain the same angle as when they were originally thrown, like this loaf of bread, or flip over themselves several times until they land, like this box of Girl Scout cookies. So what is it about a football that makes it want to tip over?
I first got interested in this problem in, I'm guessing, 2000. We published the paper in 2020, so it really was 20 years. My name is Timothy Gay. I'm an atomic physicist by day, and my secret identity is football physicist at night. The best way to understand why the ball turns over is to make an analogy with a spinning top. Spinning tops are like catnip for a physicist.
On its own, a top falls over. Give a top a spin, and it stands up. It balances itself around a line, a center point that physicists call the reference axis. This axis is determined by the main force acting on the object, which in this case is gravity. Gravity is pulling straight down, and the top is fighting this by spinning around and wobbling around this vertical line, this reference axis. A football is a top. You can spin it in the exact same way, and this is in part because of its shape. Both a football and a top are cylindrically symmetrical.
A cylindrically symmetric object is one which, if I rotate, you can't tell that I'm turning it. Objects which have this symmetry have a big impact on how the object behaves when I apply forces to it.
So when you spin them, they both wobble around a reference axis.
Spinning makes all the difference.
But once you spin a football in the air, its reference axis gets a little more complicated.
When you throw a nice spiral pass, gravity is only acting as a secondary force on the ball. Gravity is trying to pull the ball down, usually making its path to the ground look like this. But the main force acting against the ball is the air molecules that are pushing against it as it flies through the air. The ball pushes against the air, and the air pushes back against it. But because gravity makes the ball's trajectory a parabola, the air pushing against the ball changes directions as it flies. When the ball is moving up, the molecules are acting as downward pressure. When it's coming down, the molecules are pushing up. And just like the spinning top pointing against the downward force of gravity to stay vertical, the spinning football wants to push against the main force acting against it, the air molecules. Like the top on the table, the ball is going to want to wobble around its center line, its reference axis. And in this case, that ends up being the ball's trajectory, its path through the air.
What the football wants to do is exactly what the top wants to do on the table. It wants to circle, its axis wants to circle around that force direction. In the case of the top, the force of gravity never changes. It's always vertical. Whereas for the football, the axis of the force is changing.
You can see all these forces at play in this slow-mo 3D recreation. The ball takes off, pointing towards the air pushing against it and wobbling around its reference axis. It follows the trajectory gravity laid out for it, eventually reaching a point where it starts coming back down, at which point the air forces are pushing up against it and the ball points against them. But in regular motion, it just looks like the ball is tipping over.
If you threw a football without it spinning, it would follow a similar trajectory, but it wouldn't tip over. And if you tried to throw a spiral loaf of bread or some other object, it wouldn't tip over either. It only works on objects that are cylindrically symmetrical, like a football or a rugby ball.
A very smart person once said to me, "Everything is simple once explained." It's a hard problem because, first of all, there are a lot of potential explanations which seem enticing at the beginning, but turn out to be wrong. And unfortunately, you can't really solve the problem without using some relatively sophisticated mathematics, but the basic ideas are simple enough for anybody that's interested and is paying attention to understand.